Overview. It's strange how London keeps drawing me back, even though there's no specific reason. It's like every time I come here, I discover something new, even in places I thought I knew already. Maybe it's the atmosphere, that energy you breathe in the crowded streets, the blend of cultures and styles weaving through every corner. It's also the diversity of it all, from neighborhoods that seem like worlds on their own, with their peculiarities and such diverse inhabitants, to the cuisine you can find at every turn. And then there's the rhythm, always bustling yet strangely serene, that mix of frenzy and tranquility that makes the city so captivating. Tour with map. Our first stop will be the London Eye. Then, we will cross the nearby Westminster Bridge and look up to see the Elizabeth Tower. After visiting the Parliament, it will be time to explore Westminster Abbey. Alongside St. James Park, we will then reach Buckingham Palace. Another walk on the Mall, and we'll arrive at the famous Trafalgar Square. We'll stroll through the streets of London to visit the British Museum and then, thanks to the subway, reach St. Paul's Cathedral. Next, we'll cross the Millennium Bridge to admire the Tate Modern. Finally, we'll experience the thrill of riding a typical London bus, crossing the Tower Bridge, and visiting the Tower of London. London Eye. Waterloo Station is an excellent starting point as it is a major railway station where many metro lines converge. Exit on York Road and simply turn right onto Chichester Street. The London Eye is a gigantic observation will open to the public since March 9, 2000. From here, you can admire the entire city from above. With its characteristic bicycle wheel shape, it consists of 32 capsules, each capable of holding 25 people. This is where the traditional New Year's Eve fireworks are launched. Opening hours vary throughout the year, and currently, the ticket is £27. Palace of Westminster and Elizabeth Tower. Follow the Thames and cross Westminster Bridge. You'll see the Elizabeth Tower on the right. Turn right to enter the Parliament House. The Palace of Westminster is the seat of the two houses of the UK Parliament. The almost millennium-old building was almost entirely reconstructed after the fire in 1834. The palace comprises over 1,000 rooms spread across four floors, including libraries, bars, and gyms. Truth be told, I came to climb the Elizabeth Tower and see Big Ben, which not everyone knows is the nickname for the largest bell in the tower. It was a real mission since tickets for the tour are in high demand, and you have to climb 334 steps. Westminster Abbey. Cross where possible to reach the entrance on the opposite side. Westminster Abbey was built almost 1,000 years ago by Edward the Confessor. Today, it is the most important religious monument in all of England, hosting major political and religious events in the country. Buckingham Palace. Head towards Parliament Square Garden and turn left on Great George Street. A few meters, and you'll see St. James's Park. You can take a long walk in nature in the oldest royal park in the city. Buckingham Palace is the current official residence of the British monarchy and the venue for official ceremonies and banquets. The palace has 775 rooms, 1,514 doors, and 760 windows. Like hundreds of tourists, I admired the traditional changing of the guard. Prices and visiting hours change based on many factors, so it is necessary to check the official website before planning a visit. Trafalgar Square. Head towards St. James's Park, but this time on the opposite side, walking along the long road the Mall. Passing Admiralty Arch on the right, we'll find our destination.
Hey, apologies for jumping in, but I want to highlight that you'll be incredibly close to Piccadilly, arguably London's most renowned street. You can take a leisurely walk to Piccadilly Circus, where you'll be surrounded by a myriad of entertainment options, including upscale shops, theaters, and casinos. This area is an absolute must-visit, particularly for enjoying your evenings in London.
Once the Royal Stables, Trafalgar Square owes its name to the 1805 battle in which Admiral Nelson defeated the French and Spanish fleets during the Napoleonic Wars. In his honor, Nelson's column was erected, over 50 meters tall, with four lions at the corners of the pedestal. On the sides of the square, you'll find the National Gallery, South Africa House, and Canada House. British Museum. Take the road on the right as indicated on the map and keep going straight. From Tottenham Court Road, turn right onto Great Russell Street. The British Museum was founded in 1753 by the physician and scientist Hans Sloane to adequately preserve his collection of over 80,000 objects. Today, the British Museum is one of the most important museums in the world, with about 8 million objects from various eras and origins. It's so large that you won't be able to visit it leisurely in one day. Admission is free, but you can ask for the support of a guide to enjoy the experience fully. You can also visit the British Museum from home thanks to Google Street View or by following the official YouTube channel. St. Paul's Cathedral. Go back to Tottenham Court Road Station. It's time to take the Central Line, Red, towards St. Paul's, which will take us very close to our next destination. St. Paul's Cathedral is the second largest cathedral in the world, a masterpiece by architect Christopher Wren. Among the wonders to admire are the two bell towers, the organs, and the crypt where you'll find Admiral Horatio Nelson's sarcophagus. Like Westminster Abbey, historic events have been celebrated here, such as the wedding of Prince Charles and Diana and Winston Churchill's funeral. A ticket will have to be paid if you want to visit it all. Tate Modern. Arrive at the point of the cathedral indicated on the map and continue straight until you reach the futuristic Millennium Bridge. Go down the stairs, and on the left, you'll find the famous museum. Tate Modern is one of the four Tate museums in the UK and the world's most visited contemporary art museum. Formerly a power station. Among various extravagant works, you can also admire works by Pablo Picasso, Amadeo Modigliani, and Salvador Dali. Admission is entirely free, except for particular temporary exhibitions. Tower of London. Continue to the left and walk along Hopton Street. At the end of the road, on the right under the Blue Bridge, you'll find the bus stop where you can take bus number 381. There won't be much to wait, and after about 2 kilometers, get off at the Tower Bridge Road stop. Then turn left until you reach the Tower Bridge. At a certain point, still on the left, some stairs will take you down to the avenue leading to the Tower of London. This tower was built in 1078 by William the Conqueror. It has the reputation of being a bloody prison, and the mere thought of all the horrors that occurred here gave me shivers. The castle consists of 21 towers, and the most famous is certainly the White Tower, which houses the chapel of St. John the Evangelist and the arms and armor of the line of kings. To guard it all, you'll find the efficient beefeaters and the distinctive ravens.